Okay, the wind is just howling outside. It's rattling the old windows in this house. And it's also, the snow is blowing around like fine powder, which it is. Let's see what the temperature is currently. It's 25 degrees, and it's cold. And I'm going to have to do some errands today because I got to go to the post office and mail out entry forms for an art show that I'm going to be participating in March, or April, actually. I was supposed to have these in by the 20th of last month, but I didn't get the book, and so they resent me the book, and so I'm sending that out today. I'm also filling it out later on this afternoon so I can get that all out. I got it yesterday in the mail. So what I'm going to do right now, before I leave, is try to get these legs, if not finished, at least close to being finished. I gotta screw this down. Let's see, where's my screw? My drill is there. The way I'm screwing this down is I just put a screw in the base of the wax, and it's enough to hold it in place while I work on it. Light out here so I can see what I am doing. What I'm doing is just finishing up the legs, like I said, and getting them to a point of being done before I start the armature for the Eagle Dancer. I figured this morning, you know, I need to get this thing going and get it out of the way, and then I can get started on another horse later on down the road, and get it going. But for now, I'm just going to get this horse to a point of being close to being done. Now, I've got printed up drawings from books and stuff like that that I've got of the horse's anatomy, and I put them on these little cards. This is on the front leg, and what I do is I take the picture that I scan of the leg drawings, and I'll flip it in Photoshop so that the leg is in the opposite direction for the leg on the other side. So when I'm looking at it, I'm looking at it exactly the way the muscles are supposed to go. It makes it easier on me. I'm getting old and feeble. So anyway, I'm just gonna work on these legs. I'm just throwing on a quick little stem of wax to portray the height of a man on the horse. And just to see how it would look. Just experimenting. What I've done is I've taken the head measurement off the horse's head. It usually takes about 2.5 heads to make a horse's head, and that's 2.5 head lengths of a human head, and that's about the head length right there. Also, if the horse was to raise his head up, the shoulder would come even to the top of the head of the horse, and that's. You know, I pretty much eyeballed it in, and then I cut down on the shoulder a little bit. But I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet as far as the Indian goes, or cowboy, or whatever I'm going to do. Could do a naked guy on the horse, or a woman. Just not certain what I'm going to do yet. Just seeing how it looks with a rider. And I think that's as far as I'm going to go today on this one. I want to get started on the armature for the Indian, so I can start tomorrow fresh and clean on that. And so I just need to figure out the size, and I'm going to do that on my computer and I go from there. Let's see. See, you could just sketch it in. I mean, it's just no big, it's not a brainstorm here. It's just a matter of adding clay and wax or whatever, and just sort of seeing how it looks. Oops, lost his arm. One thing you don't want to do is drop your X-Acto knife on your foot, which I almost did. Let's see. All right, I stuck this on there. It's just a kind of like a fondue stick. Just to see how it looks. It's a nightmare for the foundry to try to cast something like this because of the thinness of the arm and of the spear. It makes it hard to ship, but you know, that's why we work out things like that. And I like the feel of it. Not sure if it's going to be a gun or a society staff or acoustic or what it'll be. Let's see what it looks like. Oop. Several ways of having them carry it. You know, you can carry it. Now this is the easiest way to cast it and carry it and ship it. It's not the most spectacular way. Let's see. Knocked his arm off. Okay. Just thinking of different scenarios for the possibilities or whatever. Now, that's it for today on this. I'm going to get started on the armature for the Eagle Dancer, and I'll come back in just a second. All right, I'm going to make the armature for the main body of the Indian out of copper tubing. This is 1/8-inch copper tubing that I'm using. Now the armature for the main body will be this here. I'm going to figure out head measurement now that I want to put down for this guy. And I'm going to go with, let's see. I'm going to go with a 1-inch head length. That will make it a little easier to figure out that he's going to be about 7.5 inches tall if he was to stand straight up, and he's going to be in a dancing position, so he won't be quite 7.5 inches tall. So that gives me that, and then I go 1, 2, 3, 4. That's from the top of the head to the groin. Now I'm going to drop down for the shoulder height. It's easy when you got a ruler to take the measurements off of, because it gives you exact measurements. The shoulder is about 1.5 inches down from the top of the head. And a male's between the width of the femur is about 1 head length. So the reason I'm using this copper tubing instead of something lighter is because I need some strength, because it's going to have to hold itself up. It's going to be a little bit of weight, even with wax. Now I'm going to do the upper part. I'm going to make that with baling wire. I'm going to use electrician's tape to as a binder for this. So this won't be separating when I start playing with it. What I'm doing is I've made a little circle for the head, and now I'm just that's just so the clay will stick to it, or the wax will stick to it, and has something that the wax to take purchase on. And let's just see how that works out. Oh, it's perfect. And cut off a little bit of this. And a little bit of that. Got the head armature on there. Yeah, I think I will do the arms. On something this small, I'll add the arms later, but I think it might be best to have the arms on this one, because it's going to have some strength to hold up the feathers. And so I need to Make an armature for the arms. All right, there's the armature for the Indian Dancer, and I'll get started on him tomorrow. I got to get a board to mount him on and then decide on the pose. So that's going to be it for today, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.